Do they say today's Christian women don't have to cover their heads and can lead and speak in church and Christian meetings and can sport short hair and wear unisex clothing too and are not obliged to submit to everything imposed by their husbands? If you are shocked by this statement, what if I tell you Bible says you won't go to heaven as you have not cut off your hands and gouged out your eyes as commanded in Matthew 5:29 and 30 after you have committed sins through your eyes and hands. Exodus 35:2 clearly states, whoever does any work on Sabbath day shall be put to death. Are we commanded to kill the Christians who drive their vehicles to church on Sundays? Also, the dress you are wearing right now and the vegetables and fruits you eat every day show you don't want to obey Leviticus 19 verses 19 and 27, which commands you not to eat anything made through grafting and not to wear clothes made of two kinds of threads. We know the vegetables and fruits manufactured these days are through the horticultural technique of grafting, and the dress you are wearing right now have different kinds of materials in the threads. Have you opted to disobey these commandments? Also, women, even while covering their heads in church meetings, are kind of disobeying this commandment as the clothes they use to cover their heads are made up of two kinds of material. May I ask another question? If a woman failed to cover her head, does her pastor or church leader force her to sort of shave her head off as instructed in 1 Corinthians 11:6? Why this double standard? Let's examine all these in a biblical perspective. I would request you to study the theology of hermeneutics and exegesis to know as to why we must not take some Bible verses literally. We'll be kind of convinced that the whole Bible is inerrant and infallible and there's no error at all if you follow this principle. Listen to this, please. While studying the scripture, before interpreting a verse, we must give due consideration to the context, cultural habits, historical and social background during biblical times, applying common sense, using our knowledge of language and grammar, and also understanding the poetic and figurative and metaphorical statements in the scripture. Never take certain verses literally. While reading Old Testament laws, some of which I quoted already, do you feel sort of guilty that you are not obeying them? The civil and ceremonial Old Testament laws like animal sacrifice, etc., were given to the nation of Israel at that point of time to obey and please God. Some of the laws were intended to make the Israelites distinct from other nations, like the food and clothing rules, tattoos, etc. All these laws were meant for the Israelites at that point of time only to present them different from others and are not binding on Christians today. When Jesus died on the cross, he put an end to the Old Testament laws as in Romans 10:4, which says, "For Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone who believes." Also, Galatians 3:23-25 and Galatians 6:2 confirm that faith in Christ's new covenant replaces the Old Testament laws. And Matthew 22:37-40 reiterates that if we love God and love our neighbor, we will be covering all the Old Testament laws. Though Jesus lived as a Jew, respecting all Jewish culture, he interpreted Old Testament laws in the right way by giving importance to, like, saving a son or ox fallen into a well on Sabbath day, as in Luke 14:5 and Luke 6:9, and allowing the disciples to pluck grains on Sabbath when they were hungry, as explained in Luke 6:1-5 and in Luke 6:5. Jesus says, "The Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath." Well, Paul was insisting the Corinthian church women to follow Jewish traditions like covering heads, etc., because he took great pride in his Jewish heritage by claiming it in Philippians 3:5 as having been circumcised on the eighth day of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews, in regard to the law, a Pharisee. So in 1 Corinthians 14:34 and 35, Paul says, "As in all churches of the saints, the women should keep silent in the churches, for they are not permitted to speak, but should be in submission, as the law also says. And if they desire to learn anything, let them ask their own husbands at home, for it's improper for a woman to speak in church." Also, in Ephesians 5:22-24, Paul says, "Wives, obey your husbands as you obey the Lord. The husband is the head of the wife, just as Christ is the head of the church people. The church is his body, and he saved it. Wives should obey their husbands in everything, just as the church people obey Christ. But wait, the following verses prove that Paul respected the old Jewish culture at that point of time and therefore insisted on these traditions which are not applicable to us now. In 1 Corinthians 11:2, Paul says, "Now I command you because you remember me in everything and maintain the traditions even as I delivered them to you." In 1 Corinthians 9:20, Paul says, "To the Jews I became as a Jew in order to win the Jews. To those under the law I became as one under the law, though not being myself under the law, that I might win those under the law." In Acts 22:3, Paul says, "I am a Jew born in Tarsus in Cilicia, but brought up in the city, educated at the feet of Gamaliel, according to the strict manner of the law of our fathers, being zealous for God as all you are this day." In Galatians 3:28, Paul explains, "There is neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free, nor is there male or female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus." So these examples prove Paul respected the Jewish laws and cultures of the nations he lived in, and so instructed the women to follow those traditions. In the Corinthian culture, women normally wore a head covering as a symbol of their submission to their husbands. In fact, Paul says in 1 Corinthians 11:6 that if a Christian woman refuses her head covering, she might as well shave her hair off. Does any church force women to shave their heads if they don't cover their heads? This ancient Jewish culture doesn't apply to us at all. Instructions to women not to speak in church and being indebted to obey their husbands in every way, not to wear unisex clothing, not to sport short hair, and to cover their heads, etc., were applicable to Jewish culture at that point of time only and are not applicable to us now. Wife submits to her husband because she loves Jesus. Well, in today's culture, we no longer view women wearing head coverings as a sign of submission. In most modern societies, scarves and hats are fashion accessories. The real issue is like the heart attitude of obedience to God's authority. Let me conclude by reiterating the most important point. While studying the scripture, before interpreting a verse, we must give due consideration to the context, cultural habits, historical and social background during biblical times, applying common sense, using our knowledge of language and grammar, and also understanding the poetic and figurative and metaphorical statements in the scripture. Never take certain verses literally.